by the catechists from Davao. Iyan ang ugali dito sa Mindanao. Pumipila ang mga obispo. Pumipila si Bishop Valens kaya wala kaming special place. Kaya pinulungan ko si Bishop Bobet. Bishop, pumila pa na rin. Of course, he was already standing and dying. Pero this morning, I was late because I was doing something here. I was going in and I said, where are the bishops going? And then when I was sat down and I was having my breakfast, all of a sudden, out of the blues, Cardinal Quevedo stood up and wanted to get his coffee. And I said to myself, is he standing or is he on bended knees? Before the sharing of Father Joey Escote of Santo Sé de Antique Diocese as a missionary of mercy, let's open the floor for questions from the catechists. Questions, please, and come up. Introduce yourself. Anyone? Kasi habang sariwa pa yung talk ni Cardinal. Actually, His Eminence once again reviewed BCP 2. Second Plenary Council of the Philippines. Father? Microphone. Yung susunod, please, na tayo na.
Cardinal, Father Dino from Bulacan. Regarding the biases and prejudices on Muslims, you know, many Muslims are migrating in Luzon, and our relationship with them might have been colored by these biases. How would you advise us to go over these prejudices and biases, especially we in Luzon?
So, okay, my experience is not we and they, tayo lahat. I had experience of teaching Muslims and Christians together. And for many years, 12 years of my priesthood, we're teaching Muslims and Christians at the university level. And at the university, or at the high school level, ngayon, Notre Dame of Cotabato boys and Notre Dame of Cotabato girls, run by the RBMs and run by the Maris Brothers, are more than 60% Muslim. It's a Catholic school. And the same thing is true with the Notre Dame University. It's a Catholic university, but more than 60% Muslim. What happens there is they have a dialogue of life. They mix together. Let's say, Jan kayo, dito kami. They mix together, they pray together, they all say Notre Dame. Notre Dame, pray for us. Notre Dame is Miriam. Miriam has a privileged place in the Quran. So it is a common prayer, common reverence to the Mother of Jesus, the great prophet. And the Our Father is something that is common also, universal, except that they really don't want to call Father, God as Father. Kasi Father is an image of gender, walang gender of God. We know that, but it's our own language. They don't understand. So we pray together, they study together, and then they play together, and they sometimes marry one another. One another. So, dialogue of life in school. Most of the time they live during the day in school, together with Christians. That's when they have begun respecting one another. They say, ah, ganyan pala. They see, you see students, some with the veils, ito, parang mga madre, no? And others, not, they are Christians, and they are holding hand in hand, girls. No? Christians. Christians not. In Jerusalem, there is a village in vegan of Muslims, vendors. I saw one of them in my first year in vegan in 1986. I saw one of the students who was a Muslim studying in St. Paul College of vegan. And I said to him, are you from Marawi? Are you Maranao? Opo, Maranao. Tagamindanao ako, tagamindanao ako. So, smile siya. May relative ako doon sa Cotabato. You know, ganyan. Eh, matagal na ako sa Cotabato, hindi na pawal ako eh. Pero, sabi niya, anong last name mo? Mga ganito, family names niyo, related kayo? May lulu is there, the name. That's how it happens. Just conversation, becoming friendly, begin to know one another. And the Jerusalem there, that's why. Unfortunately, they live apart. Except when they go to the market. My cook goes to the market, his suki, her suki is a Muslim. And then there's a special fish that is caught. I-separate niya yun para sa cook namin, para sa obispo. This is how it happened. It's not step one, step two, step three. It just happens. Knowing each other. But if you separate from each other, you grow up separately, you study separately, the more your biases increase. Cotabatenos, Maguindanaos, have experience in Catholic schools. Many of the Muslim rebels come from Catholic schools. The chair of the Muslim Moro Islamic Liberation Fund spent 4 years as an engineer in Notre Dame University. He did not graduate because in his fourth year, he decided to join the Moro National Liberation Front. And now he's the chair of the Moro Islamic Liberation Front. The vice chair spent 2 years in Notre Dame University. Their peace panel, the second number two peace panel member in the Lord was a university student, don't graduate, became a congressman, and married a Christian. He was in the peace panel, a student. And so on and so forth. My student in moral philosophy, ethics, was part of the panel. And then when I was stopped by the Moro Islamic Liberation Front at the highway, I rolled down my window and said, Why are you stopping us? And the Moro rebel said, sino ba kayo? Ako po, I see Bishop Quevedo. And then became respectful. Well, oh Bishop, pwede po kayo magtabi dyan kasi may RPG naka-aim sa inyo. Naka-aim na, sa Acacia Tree, naka-aim yung RPG. No, yung parang banana. Ayan. Nakapagpasuka, nagka-aim sa amin. Uy, tama, sabi ko, sige. Pero he became respectful. Sabi ko, baka graduate or student. He became respectful. You know, so that is the way it happens. It's not against step one, step two, ganito, you do this, step one, step two, you know that. It just happens by friendly conversation. By mixing with others. That's all I can say about that question.
Any other questions?
By the way, I remember I experienced myself in Germany, and I was introduced to the mass, at the mass, that an Archbishop in Cotabato would be the main celebrant. So the people were looking when the procession went to the altar. And then the people in German were talking, they said, where is the Archbishop? Because the priests were there, very tall, And the altar boys and altar girls were very tall. And then finally I passed by them. Yeah, he's the one. Kasi my head. And I could hardly be seen.
Evaluation on how is Presbyto Acts of Decrees implemented, especially on the area of being church of the poor. Because until now, we still experience the massive poverty, and it seems that maybe some of the priests are becoming rich or whatever. Thank you.
Whatever. It's been difficult to evaluate because it comes from diocese to diocese, depending on the bishops and the priests. When the priests and bishops have PCP2 in mind and renewal, the more participatory they become in church renewal. And they bring and they lead the lay people with them in church renewal. They have a vision of what their diocese should be. We do that every in Cotabato, we do it in Nueva Segovia. We do that when Igan Palayo, Nueva Segovia. We do that every number of years. We have a general pastoral assembly where we discern the situation, not like the Belgium situation. There are other issues that we have challenged with, like global warming, climate change, El Nino, La Nina, flooding, evacuations, like that. And the IPs, peace and order, so on and so forth, or new situations, and then our response, and what kind of a parish should we be in order to respond to our local issues, whether it's political, economic, or religious. And then they have the vision, that they call identity. Identity, ano sabi Sister Georgia? Identify the notes of a new vision that they have for their college. And then they program activities for the first 3 years in order to achieve the objective that they set up. That's the way it's done. Discernment, judgment, planning, and implementation. Many parishes, many dioceses in Mindanao are doing that. I'm not too sure about unfortunately, other dioceses from the outside, unfortunately, other dioceses have other concerns and parang forgotten ang BCP to vision of church. And they don't put it, they do not put input the vision of church into their church meetings and church assemblies. It is my job, as it were, to remind bishops about this. I drafted that one on preparing for the 500 years. I drafted the pastoral letter, and I, at the beginning there was a pastoral letter that had no mention at all of BCP2. So I put down the 9 major pastoral priorities for 9 years of preparation. And that's how BCP2 became again placed in the center of the consciousness of visions. But very often, nawala, as we say in Cebuano, nawala, consciousness, depending on bishops. Remuneration, poverty, itong ginawa namin sa Vigan. And it's something that I'm trying to begin again, but very difficult in Cotabato. In Vigan, I asked them, do you feel uncomfortable with regard to what they call the collections or stipends for what do you call that? Toll fees for baptism, confirmation, you know, and my first class, my second class, my third class, marriages, funerals. Kung may first class ka na funeral, maraming bakting ang van. And kung wala, you hire your own van. And then first class marriage, mungka-mungka, many witnesses, many yung sponsors, governors, and all that. Don't you feel uncomfortable when the poor people cannot afford what to do? Parang mercenary, di ba? And sabi ng mga pari, yeah, pero that's the way we are. No, let us change. Let us have a new way of supporting the church. And I introduced modified tithing. One vicariate said, we will experiment with modified tithing. We will go from barrio to barrio, this becoming of several parishes, and we shall educate the people on modified tithing. And the motto we will use is, everything comes from the Lord. We return something to the Lord. And that something that we return to the Lord is a pledge. Each family comes together, husband, wife, and children. How much can we give to the church every month? And they say, Papa, siguro kung mag-stop ka ng sigarilyo, marami tayo bibigay. Eh, hindi ako pwede mag-survive kung wala sigarilyo. Oh, sige, one pack na lang. Okay, siya. Pwede naman siguro, they discuss. No? They discuss what can be done. And one, can pledge 5 pesos, 20 pesos, 500 pesos, 1,000 pesos every month for modified tithing as a pledge. But important that money collection is from the people and by the people. Hindi pwede pari, Kasi, how? Ano mo naman? There's a second floor report, and there's a first floor report. So, finance council must be activated. The finance council of the parish, the finance council of the barangay, they must be activated. They are in charge of collections of the monthly pledges, and they are offered at the church or in the chapel when the priest comes. There is a board. Check, 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 check. Sa kanila, yan. They did not say, ito ang passport to heaven. If you are not, your name is not checked, sorry. No, it's just to show that there is a pledge and it's being kept. You can find out. When that happened, if the priest went there once a month to celebrate the Mass, he has barely 500, 600 peso collection. Ngayon, when he celebrates that, the monthly tithe is triple, quadruple the amount that is given every month. And with that, sabi ng Paris ng Bikari, this is what, this is the result of a modified tithe after education in faith. Sabi nila, okay, with that, do you think you can survive by eliminating arancel, the arancel, the toll fees? Of course, because the toll fees amount to this much every month. Pero modified tithing is triple, quadruple the amount that is raised. So we can eliminate. No more toll fees for baptism, confirmation, marriages. Yan ang nangyari ito. Church of the poor. All the people contribute to modified tithing. So much so that one priest received a Honda Civic flashy from his relatives in the States. Kasi maraming mga balikbayan, maraming Ilocanos in the States, especially in Hawaii. You go to Hawaii, you think you are in an Ilocano town. And you go and say, are you Filipino? And the manager would say, no, I'm Ilocano. Ganyan. Okay, he received a flashy Honda Civic. This was about 1997, 1 year before I left. And the priest saw that car. Oh, wow. They went down to take a look at it, wiping that, church of the poor, church of the poor, church of the poor. And nahiyak yung pari. In 3 days, wala na yung Civic Honda. He returned it to his relatives. Because of that pressure, Church of the Poor. And they have that. Number two, they standardized ang salaries, allowances. No matter where you are, rich or poor parish, it's the same amount that is given. Extra amount is for years of service and the kind of job that you have. Parish priest, assistant, director of a school, whatever it is, there is a difference of it. But the same starting salary for everybody. So the priests who used to keep that money, because they are from rich, they can no longer ambition to be in a rich parish. Sana, doon ako sa cathedral kasi mayaman, marami akong pera doon. Hindi. Standardized. So much so that the reverse becomes true. Yung mga matatanda, sabi niya, Bishop, anyway, since the salaries are the same, doon na lang ako sa small parish para pupunti lang trabaho ko. Old naman ako eh. That is the reverse that happens. Pero yan ang nangyari sa Bishop. That is what I'm trying to do also in Adias Dias and Sokatamat. So, yun ang church ng we are trying to do that. It's difficult. I do not know how many dioceses would have some kind of policy like that. Modified tithing as a form of support. Arancel already eliminated. But yung Archbishop po, yung Archbishop, sino yung nagsabi ng Archbishop so kanina sa misa? Sabi niya, he has been reported as expressing no more, we are moving towards that one. No more feasts or sacraments. Every marriage in Ilocos Sur is first class. Why? Because the parish choir provides the choir, the parish provides the roses or whatever they have, the entourage and all that. And there can be two or three weddings at the same time. Because it's all first class. Okay?
Any other questions?
Very quiet kayo. What are you thinking of? Sana ganyan sa amin. Yes, there is one here. Sana ganyan sa amin.
Good morning, Cardinal. Bingham here po from Pasig. We're talking about renewal and change, no? Possible change for church governance. So, I believe that every year the bishops twice meet for a plenary, and usually after each plenary you have the pastoral statement. And I believe that this year, last July, no pastoral statement was written or released by the bishops. The first question is why? Because I believe, coming from other questions, there are issues from each diocese that contextualize, meaning depending sa kultura. But there are issues that, kasi I'm coming from that we, Filipinos, this is just my personal opinion. The church here in our country is too hierarchical still. We follow as lay, I'm a lay, we still follow what our shepherds are telling us. But I'm not saying na maghihintay lang kami. The second point is the voice of the church about these killings, talking about social justice and renewal. And I'm afraid with the silence of each bishop per diocese. Because the killings is not only in Manila, but also national level.
Number one, first question, where was there no pastoral letter? Bishop, Archbishop Villegas asked for a pastoral letter to be drafted. He asked me to draft a pastoral letter. It was one of the most difficult pastoral letters I wrote because one is we were waiting for President Digo to actually do, is he going to do exactly what he wanted to do? Is he going to do what he has done in Davao, like human rights violation, killings without due process, and killings by vigilantes? The vigilantes, I understand, were being done by disparo units of the NPA. That's why he was close to calling to them, or he was close to the NPAs. And so on and so forth. His promises of change, is he really going to do that? So we did not know. So it was difficult for me to write. But I did write a pastoral letter, draft. And the title that I gave to it was Called to Discern, Discerning the First Year of Digong, to find out promise to fulfillment and how. Number two, sent to mission. Mission is change, to change the social situation. So that was the title that I gave. I left and Bishop Villegas said, you have to wait for the discussion tomorrow. I said, I'm sorry, I have to leave. So I didn't know and I texted the executive secretary, what happened to the pastoral letter? Was it changed? Was it approved? And he said, the bishops decided not to issue a pastoral letter. I really do not know why. maybe some bishops said, let's wait and see what happens. And maybe it's time now, through the permanent council of the bishops, to say something about extrajudicial killings. That one. Groups of people, including lay people, have come out with that statement. CAP is coming out of the American Junior Association of the Philippines, as I read in the reports. Individual bishops have cried about that. But maybe the permanent council should say something about that. I'm not part of the permanent council, but I would like to see something happen. But Bishop Maliari might know, because he might be in the permanent council.
Wala bonus na permanent council, but I was still there when the decision was made that we will not make a pastoral letter because we will try to do a new strategy instead of writing a pastoral letter, form a group of bishops and then go to President Digong and present the issues and concerns of the bishops to him directly because we realize that when he reads something in the media, he reacts immediately. And he would say so many things and then withdraw them afterwards. So we thought it would be better if we form a group of bishops and then present the concerns of the bishops to him personally. So yun po yun. And then yung sinasabi po ni Cardinal, it was also encouraged that each individual bishops in their respective dioceses will write their pastoral letters if they need to write a pastoral letter regarding these issues. Especially po kung yung mga extrajudicial killings if they're happening in the diocese. So yung individual bishop is responsible to write a pastoral letter dun sa kanyang diocese.
Thank you very much, Bishop, for the information. It's the first time I know that. I was not told about it by Father Mejia. And I think it's a good decision because anything made public is counterproductive. Especially when the pastoral letter can be interpreted one way or the other. And President Digong will thank you to the Pastor Bishop. Kayo mag-obisto po. Hypocrites ka mo. It's against 5 bishops. Not all the bishops. And you know them because they were vocal against the Digong during the elections. But the other one is, it's nice, I think. If we did that once with Gloria Macapagal, I think a group of bishops were tasked to see Gloria Macapagal Coroy at certain happenings, Hayat, and Kayak, and so on and so forth during the crisis. So now you know also kung ano nangyari doon. Of course, something like that does not get to the press. I do not know what kind of courtesy visit Cardinal Tagle had with President Digong and Coroy, the other part of Coroy. They went, but I don't think it's simply hello and goodbye. Something like that would be substantial. Yeah. I wish I had your height. By the way, the one from Pasig, are you related to Milo? Bishop Milo? Ano? You're beginning to be like Bishop Milo in face. He will, by the way, be the retreat master of the bishops, U.S. bishops, next year.
I'm going to go with the my question was regarding social justice. Okay, in relation to social justice, President Bito came out with freedom of information. I thought that government actions and sanctions would be transparent and we have voted in the future, including that extension of access and measures of all government employees. I was just thinking about if we can follow that in the future.
For freedom of information in the church.
Yes.
Yeah. You know, because it is my policy to report financial finance to all the priests and the clergy, the diocesan and clergy, it's reported. And I started it in Vigan. Even my own financial reports were given, and the priests were wondering, why are you giving financial reports the first time? But you know, a bishop in 400 years will give a financial report of his own expenses. I do that so that you can follow. Huh? I hope there is freedom of information and so within the church.
Thank you so much.
There should be no first ground report, financial report, and the second floor report. The second floor is from the parish priest. Iba yung parish priest report, but it reaches the diocese from that of the first ground. Na doctor na yun. Yeah. Again, it's very difficult, no? The finances of dioceses are very often secret. Secret to everybody except the bishop and his council. I would say, bakit wala kayong financial report in this? It's owned by the diocese, and therefore there should be a financial report to all the clergy. Mahirap ako ha. What are you fighting? Maybe their own, what they call in ablative absolute in Latin. Kita is ano? Is profit there? Ano ang kita? Income. It becomes ablative absolute. Kita is kita is. You know? You have your income and can be changed as you will.
Eminence, we thank you for sharing. Let us give.
Maraming salamat sa inyong tanan. Ano yung tanan? Katayawan Festival karon. But be careful with the speed limit. Speed limit and smoking in public. You will be fined. Salamat po.
For a sharing, we will request Father Joselito Escote of the Diocese of San Jose to do a sharing on his being a missionary of mercy. And you welcome him, please.